I'm Raj Singh. I work with LSU AgCenter and I'm an extension horticulture pathologist, and I deal with horticulture crops including blackberries. And this morning we're going to discuss some of the important diseases of blackberries that we have here in the state. Blackberries are susceptible to a lot of different diseases, but there are some that can cause adverse effect on the growth and the berry production. Some are more common here are leaf spots, and there are several different fungal pathogens that can cause leaf spots. There is septoria, there is anthracnose. More common that we have here is the rust. There are two different kind of rust that can occur on blackberries. One is your cane and leaf rust, and there's another orange rust. In order to differentiate them, the cane and leaf rust will cause pustules on the canes as well as the pustules on the underside of the leaves, whereas the orange rust will only cause the pustules on the underside of the leaf. Here I have a very good specimen where you can see it's just starting to produce those pustules on the bottom of the leaf. You can see they are orange in color, so that's why we call it orange rust. In terms of leaf spots, you can see I'm holding a leaf with leaf spots, and these leaf spots, you have to take them to the lab in order to identify which particular pathogen is causing the disease. Okay, based on the shape, some are more circular, some are irregular, and sometimes you will see some of the fruiting bodies of that fungus inside those spots, and that way you can tell which particular pathogen is causing that disease. When it comes to fruit, we have one big problem with fruit rot, which is caused by botrytis. Now, it can start causing the damage on the cane, and then the flowers will shrivel, and once the fruit is present, the fungus will move to the fruit and causes it water soaked, and then you will start seeing a lot of white mycelium, fuzzy white mycelium on the fruits, and then you cannot harvest those fruits. We have another big problem here with blackberries, which is called double rosette virus, double rosette disease. And that disease is also a fungal disease. In that case, what happens once you have an infected bud, it will produce several shoots from the same location and gives it a witch's broom kind of appearance. Another important disease that we have in the state is Phytophthora root rot. In that case, the roots will start to rot because the pathogen is soil borne, and it will start rotting the roots, and then you start seeing the foliage will start wilting, and then the canes will start dying. So those are some of the very important diseases that we have here in Louisiana on blackberries. When it comes to disease management, I always recommend to implement an integrated disease pest management strategies, because it's very important to make sure that your plants are growing vigorously, they are as healthy as it can be, then they can defend themselves against those pathogens. If your plants are stressed out, they are highly susceptible to those diseases. So in terms of cultural practices, you may want to clean up some of the dead dying twigs after you harvest the fruit, because that's where some of the pathogens are going to overwinter, and they will serve as inoculum for next year disease infections. Also, overhead irrigation is not recommended in blackberries, because you got some water splash spores that will transfer when you have an overhead irrigation. They will transfer to healthy tissue. Also, soil compaction and water drainage is a big issue here. So you want to make sure that before you plant any blackberries, make sure that your soils are well drained. There is no compaction, because once you have soil compaction, you will start seeing water drainage issues. And when the roots sit in extended period, roots sit in excess water, when the root zone is saturated with water, you will start seeing they will rot, and then the pathogens will come and they start infecting those stressed out roots. So it's very important that you don't want to just rely on the chemicals or the fungicides in order to have the disease management. If you do cultural practices incorporated with your chemical spray programs, you will have better chance managing these diseases. Thank you.